Welcome back students. In today's class we will talk about the symmetrical pi network. Already we have discussed about the symmetrical T network and the characteristic impedance and propagation constant of a symmetrical T network. Now symmetrical pi network is also an important network in the transmission lines. So these network will be having series arm impedances and shunt arm impedances. Respectively, there are Z1 and Z2. Series arm impedance and shunt arm impedance are Z1 and Z2 for the pi network. Symmetrical pi network, you should have Z1 and Z2 as the series and shunt arm impedances respectively. So we will draw a pi network now. A symmetrical pi network is given like this. If you have a resistance, or you can call it impedance also, this impedance, and here it is one more impedance. This particular network is called as a pi network. It is resembling a pi. So we call it as a pi network. Okay, now here the series and shunt arm impedances. Shunt arm impedance means, as you know, these are the shunt arm impedances and this is the series impedance. Okay, now shunt arm impedances are respectively given here 2Z2 and 2Z2. Here it is given as Z1, series arm impedance. Okay, this is 1 1 dash, and this is 2 2 dash. Okay, we call it as symmetrical pi network. Symmetrical pi network. This figure is symmetrical pi network, where you are having Z1 as the series arm impedance, and these are the shunt arm impedances 2Z2 and 2Z2. We know that shunt arm impedance is nothing but the parallel. So if you do 2Z2 into 2Z2 divided by 2Z2 plus 2Z2. Why? Because whenever the parallel impedances are given, you have to write R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. So by making this two shunt impedances 2Z2 into 2Z2 by 2Z2 plus 2Z2, you will get only Z2 value. So we know that in a symmetrical pi network or in a symmetrical T network, we should have these series arm impedances and shunt arm impedances as Z1 and Z2 only. So we can write the pi network in this form. It is Z1, no problem here. So Z1 is the series arm impedance, only one it is there, so we are writing it. But in a pi network, we are having two shunt arm impedances. So the value should be 2Z2 and 2Z2. If you multiply R1, R2, 2Z2 into 2Z2 by 2Z2 plus 2Z2, this one will be 4Z2 square divided by 4Z2. If you see here, you get answer Z2. So this is nothing but only Z2. So after making that solving Z1 and this 2Z2 as a parallel, it becomes only Z2. So series arm impedance is Z1 and shunt arm impedance is Z2 respectively now. Okay. Now we will see how to write these expressions. Okay. As we have already solved for the T network, now we will solve for the pi network. So we will here write the expressions similar to T network. We should find here the characteristic impedance Z0 and propagation constant gamma respectively. So we have done already the Z0 and gamma in the T network. Now similarly, we have to find out this characteristic impedance as well as the propagation constant for a pi network as well. Now we will write the characteristic impedance in terms of the series arm impedance and shunt arm impedances. As we have done in T network, now we will write this one in terms of series impedance and shunt impedances. Z1 and Z2 are the series and shunt impedances. So we will write Z0 in the form of Z1 and Z2 now. So we will write here characteristic impedance. Characteristic impedance Z0. Or we can write Z0 of pi because it is for a pi network. Or else you can leave it like this. So Z0 is for pi network. For pi network. Okay. So how to find out the characteristic impedance Z0 for the pi network? So we have to consider a pi network first. We will draw this pi network. So we are drawing a pi network here with the series and shunt arm impedances, that is 2Z2 and 2Z2, and here it is Z1, 1, 1 dash, and it is 2, 2 dash. So here, as in a symmetrical network, already we have discussed that there is this is Zin, input impedance. Now, what we have to do for finding out this characteristic impedance, we have to connect here Z0. We have to connect here Z0. This is called as Z0. In a symmetrical network, if we are connecting Z0 here, then what it this circuit is called as symmetrical pi network. It is called as a symmetrical pi network terminated with Z0. Terminated with Z0. If you are terminating this one at Z0 at this side, second port, then what we want to find out is Zin. Actually, in a symmetrical network, Zin is equals to Z0 also. Whenever you are talking about the symmetrical network, you should write Zin is equals to Z0. If you are writing here Z0, then this will be equal to the Z in value here. Okay. In a symmetrical network, remember this point that on the input side, if you are output side, if you are connecting Z0, then this Z0 should be on the input side also. So Z in is equals to Z0. Okay. Now we will write the equations for this. How to write the equations for this is first of all we have to find out the Z in is equal to Z0 is equal to this series and parallel connections we have to solve and write the equations. By the property of the symmetrical network, we will write this Z in is equal to the formula for it. What is the property of symmetrical network? Z in should be equal to Z naught. Z in should be equal to Z naught. So you will write that one first. Z1 is equals to Z in is equals to Z in is equals to Z naught is equals to what is Z naught? Z in is equals to Z naught. So we will find out the value of Z in here. So how to find out the Zin value? After finding out the Zin value, we will tell that this Zin is, can be written as Z0. Okay. Zin is equals to 2Z2 parallel to 2Z2 is parallel to Z1 plus Z1 plus 2Z2 parallel to Z0. This is the equation you have to write. So you can observe here, this is 2Z2 and 2Z2 is parallel to, parallel symbol I am writing here. 2z2 is parallel to z1 and plus z1 plus these two are parallel, no? 2z2 into z0 by 2z2 plus z0. So these two are parallel. So after combining this one, this parallel, it becomes in series with this one, z1 plus this total combination. So what we write here is 2z2 plus 2z2 parallel to, because this is also a parallel, so with the junction here, 2z2 is parallel to z1 plus this total network. After solving this parallel network, in this conjunction it becomes a series network. After solving this one, it is in series with this one. So we have written here z1 plus z1 plus 2z2 parallel to z0. This is separate one and this is separate. So these are in series, this one and z1. Now 2z2 is parallel with all this combination. So we have written 2z2 parallel to z1 plus 2z2 parallel to z0. Now we will simplify this. After writing this one, we will simplify. So what we can write here, 2z2 is parallel to z0 is equals to 2z2 parallel to z1 plus, we will open this bracket first, we will simplify step by step, 2z2 into z0 divided by 2z2 plus z0, r1 r2 by r1 plus r2, these are in parallel. So we have done writing like this. After that one, now z0 is written, z0 is equals to, we are not opening this bracket, 2z2 parallel to, we are multiplying, cross multiplying this one, z1 into 2z2 plus z0 plus 2z2 z0 divided by 2z2 plus z0. Step by step you have to remove the brackets here. So this is the equation, 2z2 is parallel to z0 is equals to 2z2 parallel to this complete equation. After writing this equation, what we do here is, these two equations are parallel to each other. So what we can write here, z0 is equals to 2z2 into, now let us open these brackets also, 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 z0 divided by 2z2 plus z0. Now this is the simplified equation. After removing this bracket also, z0 is equals to, we have got this value. After getting this value, what we write here is z0 is equals to 2z2 parallel to 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 z0 by 2z2 plus z0. Okay. Already we have solved here, z0 is equals to this step. Now further simplification can be done now. The further simplification is the just removing the braces and writing as a parallel equation. After writing this equation as parallel equation, what we get here is 2z2. 2z2 is parallel to this equation. So we'll write r1 r2 by r1 plus r2 form. So z0 is equals to, this is z0. Z0 is equals to 2z2, that is r1, we treat as r1 and r2, r1, r2, this is r1, this is r2, this complete equation is r2, 2z2 into 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 z0 divided by 2z2 plus z0 whole divided by R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. No? Now we have to add this one. 2Z2 plus 2Z1 Z2 plus Z1 Z0 plus 2Z2 Z0 divided by 2Z2 plus Z0. So it is the form R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 form. This is plus here, this is multiplication. Now what we do is here, we will simplify further this one. This equation we will simplify now. So this is having 2Z2 plus Z0, these two gets cancelled. These two gets cancelled, and before getting it cancelled, what we do here is we will simplify further. 2z2 into 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 z0 divided by 2z2 plus z0 whole divided by 4z square, z2 square, 4z2 square plus 2z2 z0 plus 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 z0 plus 2z2 z0. So divided by 2z2 plus z0. Now these terms gets cancelled. After getting these terms cancelled, what we can write here is implies that 2z2 into 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 z0 divided by 4z2 square plus 2z2 z0 plus 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 z0. Okay? Now cross multiplying this z0 and this equation, what we get here is 4z2 square z0 plus 2z2 z0 square plus 2z1 z2 z0 plus z1 z0 square plus 2z2 z0 square is equal to 2z2 into 2z1 z2 plus z1 z0 plus 2z2 into z0. So after cross multiplication we are equating these terms. What we get here is 4z2 square z0 plus 2z2 z0 square plus 2z1 z2 z0 plus z1 z0 square plus 2z2 z0 square is equal to, you can open this bracket and write 4z1 z2 square plus 2z1 z2 z0 plus 4z2 square z0. So if you see here this equation and this equation after cross multiplication of these, we get this particular value. Okay, if you see here,
there are some common terms which can be cancelled. This is a common term, this is a common term, LHS and RHS side. And what else are the common terms you can cancel here? That is 4Z2 square Z0. Here also 4Z2 square Z0 is there. And also you are having here only 4Z1 Z2 square on the RHS side, and on the LHS side you are having 2Z2 Z0 square plus 2Z2 Z0 square. It can become 4Z2 Z0 square, this one and this one, which are not cancelled, plus Z1 Z0 square is equals to 4Z1 Z2 square. After simplification of all the terms, we get this value. Now we will take common Z0 square is equals to, Z0 square is common, taken common here. What we can write here is 4Z1 Z2 square by Z1 plus 4Z2. Z1 plus 4Z2. Now after multiplying this by 1 by 4, numerator and denominator by 1 by 4 for this equation, what we get the value we will see now. Multiplying the numerator and denominator by 1 by 4, we will see here. Denominator by 4 by Z1 by 4, Z1 by 4. What we get here, we will see. This is a factor. Multiplying the numerator and denominator by a factor Z1 by 4. So Z0 square is equals to, if you are multiplying by Z1 by 4, what does this equation become? You will see now. Four into Z1 Z2 square into Z1 by 4 divided by Z1 by 4 into Z1 plus 4Z. So here it is equal to 4Z1 square Z2 square. So by 4 and 4 gets cancelled, divided by Z1 square by 4 plus 4 and 4 gets cancelled after entering, after there multiplying, 4 and 4 gets cancelled here and remaining is Z1 Z2. So we can all remove the squares. Here it is square, here it also it is a square value, so Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. So we can remove here the brackets. So if you square root it, it becomes Z1 Z2 by square root of Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. That is equals to Z1 You see here Z1 square by 4, Z1 square, Z2 square, it is Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2 is equal to Z0 square. Now if you want to remove Z0, what is Z0? Z0 is equals to Z1 Z2 under root of Z1 square Z2 square by Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. This becomes, so square gets cancelled and square root Z1 Z2 divided by square root of Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2 under root. Okay. So what is this equation? Z1 Z2 by Z0 of t.
Why? Because in the symmetrical T network, what we have got, that Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2 is nothing but characteristic impedance of the T network. So we can write here Z0 is equal to Z1 Z2 by Z0 of T. We can write also here, this equation can be written, this is the pi impedance, characteristic impedance of the pi network. So we can write this one as Z0 pi is equals to Z1 Z2 by ZOT. So this is the characteristic impedance of the pi network in terms of the series arm impedance, shunt arm impedance, as well as the characteristic impedance of the T network. Okay. So here Z0 pi, that is nothing but characteristic impedance of the pi network, characteristic impedance of pi network, that is Z0 pi, in terms of Z1 comma Z2 and characteristic impedance of the T network ZOT. So this is the equation. Okay, I will like to conclude the class here, students. That is the finding out the characteristic impedance of a pi network in terms of the Z1, Z2 and Z0T. Okay, we will next study about the characteristic impedance in terms of the open circuit, short circuit and the propagation constant of a pi network. Thank you.